It's nothing.
I'm throwing it away.
No.
Hey, chill out.
What's that?
What's up?
It's a lot of papers. It says, Malaysia truly Asia. Sounds interesting. A country embodied with beautiful earth, traditions, and culture. An aspect that we would like to delve into is our traditional games, which are famous among the Malay community. Traditional games provide a reliable framework for enjoyable play, as well as opportunities for creativity and exploration. That being said, we will be focusing on Ceper, Ketingting, and Batu Seremban.
The next time you open a new bottle with steel caps, do not throw them away. You can recycle them, or even better, use them to play Ceper. Ceper, a game played with 5 steel bottle caps and 2 or more players. The game originated from the late 1970s. The game can be played on any workable surfaces as long as it's flat and smooth. How do we play? It's simple. Determine who starts first. Put all 5 Cepers on your palm. Throw them in the air and try to catch as many as you can using the back of your palm, and then lob again to catch. One Ceper represents 2 points. The order of the play is determined by the number of points collected in one go. Once that's settled, the second part of the game begins. Stack the caps flat side facing downwards and spin the Ceper. Choose a Ceper to be removed from the play. Another player will choose for you which Ceper to shoot at and in what order. This needs concentration, focus, and skills. When successful, the player goes into part 3 of the game. The player will lob the Ceper to get points. The one with the most points win the game. But be careful not to fall into these situations. Situation 1. Ceper Ayam. When 2 Cepers overlap, the player will have to re-spin the Cepers. Situation 2. Ceper Jamban. Stack the Ceper in a pyramid form. Distance the remaining Ceper by choosing a finger of your opponent. The player will then shoot the Ceper over the pyramid stacked Ceper. The player will then shoot the Ceper over the pyramid stacked Ceper. Situation 3. Ceper Pagar. When 4 Ceper is touched in a line, the player needs to align and distance all Ceper straight and determine the distance by the opponent's finger. And the last situation. Ceper Bunga. When 4 Ceper is stacked on each other, the player will then need to stack all Ceper into a pyramid form. The player then needs to press from the top of the Ceper to distance out the Ceper. With that being said, Ceper is a simple and straightforward game to play with your friends.
Thank you.
What about the other two games?
It says Ketinting.
Ketinting?
Yeah.
I used to play this when I was a kid.
Thank you.
Ka-ting-ting, which is a famous game among children. Ka-ting-ting is known all over the world, and each place the rules of Ka-ting-ting differ. Besides the popular name hopscotch, in English, Ka-ting-ting is also known as Buat Rumah Batu, Ting-ting, Chiak Ting-ting. The history behind Ka-ting-ting is that it was first used by Roman troops as a form of military instruction to develop their physical stamina and fortitude. Therefore, children in Rome started to observe and mimic the warrior's training. Now, it has migrated and influenced other countries, becoming a children's jumping game and encourage physical and mental growth while having fun. Ka-ting-ting is typically played by girls instead of boys due to the fact it is an easy game that does not require intense movement. This game consists of 2 to 4 players. However, it may cause difficulty for players if more than 4 players in one court. The props needed are chucks to draw the boxes, while gundu with the size of 50 cent coin are objects to be tossed into the boxes. Common gundu objects used are broken plates, iron pieces, and flat stones. Everyone should have their own gundu to represent themselves in the game. Besides that, Ka-ting-ting was just an outdoor game in the past, so it requires open ground and a flat surface. In that case, avoid lawn areas due to the requirement of drawing boxes using chalks. However, in the modern era, children now play Ka-ting-ting outdoors and also indoors using picnic blankets, foam mats, and float stickers instead of going to the difficulty of drawing with chalk and from scratch. Before the game starts, player will conduct a quick play of Lat-tali-lat-tali tamplum to determine the arrangement of who goes first, second, third, and so on. To start the first round, a player will toss the gundu into the first square and should jump into individual squares with 1 foot, while with both feet for the pair of squares while skipping the box where the gundu landed on. Then, the player is required to jump back and collect the gundu before the next round. This goes the same way up to the 9th round while avoiding stepping on the house. After completing all 9 rounds, the player is required to toss the gundu up and balance it at the back of their hand. Then, the player must jump in and back to the starting line without dropping it. Finally, the player should toss the gundu into any squares while facing back. Once the gundu lands on any of the boxes, the player should write their name in the box to determine its win. Lastly, there are simple restrictions to avoid while playing Ka-ting-ting. If the gundu does not go into the specified square during a round or completely goes out from any of the boxes, the player is considered dead and lose its turn. For example, if it is the second round and the player fails to toss the gundu to the second box, the player has lost their turn and has to wait until the other players complete their round. Apart from that, if a player steps on the box's line, the other player will take over the game. Unlike this active group of friends, some people might prefer a game that involves less movement. For this, we have Batu Seremban, a traditional game played by people of all generations. While there is no specific person who created this game, it is a well-known game in Kedah, Selangor, Kelantan, and Johor. Other names for this game are Batu Selambut or Seremban. The game is played individually, usually in a group of 2 to 4 people, typically girls. The location to play this game is on a flat, clean surface to allow players to catch the Batu Seremban efficiently. As for the tools, the common props used are small objects known as buah. Some examples of buah include rubber seeds, glass, or even small pebbles, which are stand wrap using a cloth known as kain batik. The batik serba is made using a few pieces of cloth which are sewn and filled up with small objects. In this video, the batik serba are filled with small dry green beans. After finishing up sewing the batik serba, it can now be used in the gameplay. For this traditional game, there is no time limit. Before the game starts, the player will need to toss their buah into the air and balance it out on their hands. Afterwards, the buah, which is placed on the hand, is needed to be caught without the buah falling down. The number of buah that are catched are the points that the player has. It is to determine the sequence of who will be playing first until the last player. If the player fails to catch the buah, they are considered to have 0 points. The game starts when the player's turns are chosen. At each level, each buah is thrown in a different way. There are a total of 7 levels in Batik Serba. The rounds go from easy to the most difficult. At the start of the first level, the fruits are thrown one after the other into a reachable range in the air. In the next level, players will continue to play until they hit fruit 7 or king. For points, the player will hold the buah on one hand. If they catch the buah, they can play again without having to switch partners. If no one was able to catch the buah, the player must stop the game and pass the turn to the next person. This is called die or mati permainan. Other ways of how a player needs to pass their turns are when they fail to catch any buah or when they accidentally came in contact with the other fruits. This leads them to mati permainan.
Thank you.
and all, traditional games are important because they contribute to cultural preservation, social bonding, physical and cognitive development, education, stress relief, cultural exchange, sustainability, historical understanding, and intergenerational connections. They enrich our lives by connecting us to the cultural roots and promoting various aspects of personal and societal well-being.